1:36 left to play in the second half. A chance to put the Griffins back on top. Hoga, 7-for-7 from the line. Has that one bank out. It'll be rebounded by Billy Kerr, so the Profs will stay alive, tied at 61.
Right on cue. The missed free throw.
Minute and a half left to play. They'll get it back. Billy Kerr holding up high, top of the key, guarded tightly by Lemire Terry. Redden over to Spellman, far side wing, 15 seconds. Spellman lost the dribble, feeding inside. Dan Redden trying to go up off the glass. He falls down. No foul and no basket. Quentin Mercy back the other way, and Spellman draws the charge. Heads up play by the senior, and it'll be Rowan basketball. The guilty party there, John Crabtree.
What a great play by Spellman. Drawing the charge, heads up, cognizant of the fact that even though the ball was pretty much halfway down and popped out, you still got to play defense. Didn't caught his defender off guard, and he was just perched there right at half court and was able to draw the charge. And that's a huge, huge play with 1:09 to go as the towel comes in again. It will get wiped off. 1:09 to go, 61 all. Both teams in the double bonus.
Profs will stack it up. It'll be Redden, Darby, Kerr, Aaron Spellman, and Tyson Hart of the five bodies on the court for Joe Cassidy with 1:09 left to play in the second half. And they can bring the towel boy back out. 1:09 to go. The court's still a little bit slick. Profs will run the stack on the inbound. We are deadlocked at 61 in a pretty exciting game for a non-conference game. And not a big crowd on hand, although it is filling in, but a lot of excitement here at SB Gym.
Well, the boys' home opener, the crowd, which is pretty filled up for a Tuesday before Thanksgiving in a non-conference game. They're seeing a good one.
Dan Redden holds it up high right in front of our table. He'll throw it into the backcourt for Aaron Spellman. Fresh 35 on the shot clock, just over 1 minute left to play. Spellman running the point, the senior captain will give it up. Here's Billy Kerr. Kerr guarded tightly by McCauley. He'll kick it out far side wing. Here's Dan Redden trying to penetrate. 18 on the shot clock. Aaron Spellman back outside. Good job guarding the paint by Gwen and Mercy. Back out to Hartnett. The transfer leaves it off for Spellman with 11.
You want to get a shot off to get a 2-for-1. Get the ball back with more than 35 seconds to go.
Here's Kevin Darby. Loses the dribble out of bounds, and it'll go the way of the Griffins. Not a good offensive set for the Profs. Couldn't quite pull the trigger on a shot, and they turn the ball over with 38 seconds to go. They will be guaranteed to get it back, but Gwen and Mercy, they'll have the basketball, the chance to try to break this 61 all tie.
And if you want to try to extract a positive out of that, it is that there are 35 seconds left. College shot clock, 35 seconds. So you will get the ball back, barring a foul with less than 14 seconds to go on the shot clock.
And with just under 34 seconds left to play, head coach John Barron and the Gwen and Mercy Griffins will call a timeout. That's their fourth of the game. They have two remaining. And we have a good battle here brewing. 61 all, 34 seconds left to play. We will stop the clock there, and it'll be interesting to see what Gwen and Mercy does here, because their bread and butter this season has been the long-range shot. But like I said before, Corey, ice cold is rather a way to sugarcoat how bad they've been from behind the arc. They do have the size, so expect maybe Dave Smith to come back into the game. Even though he only has 8 points, they do have a size advantage, and right now all you need is one bucket, tied at 61.